Yo, what up, AfterBuzz? It's DJ Jesse here. I'm here with Abram from MTV. What's going on, sir?
Yeah.
All right, we're gonna get some translations for that at the bottom. You're here at the Vegas Bash. Is this your first Vegas Bash? I'm just gonna get this on camera. You're gonna allow us to actually put whatever we want as those subtitles?
Okay. All
right, what has MTV done?
What do you got going on?
All right, what I do want to ask you is, you know, are you watching the challenge? Are you watching the new Real Worlds?
Nope.
Not at all.
Nope. I actually think the shows that we did are the downfall of civilization. I tell people that all the time. Don't watch them. I don't watch them myself, not even the ones I film.
So the downfall of civilization, what made you actually want to join, be on the show?
Because they're a ton of fun to go do. It's one thing to go out and go film them and have fun and to enjoy it. And it's experience. I mean, the challenge. I mean, like, there's no weight classes. It's a surprise with each challenge. It's not like you get it built up and trained for a soccer match and you know who you're going against. It's not like a boxing match where you know the guy's going to be in your weight class. You're going against people that it's an unknown situation, and it creates a catalyst in the mind where there's an element of fear and surprise that really makes the competition far more enjoyable. And I thrive on that, and I love that.
So now, as far as the downfall of civilization, where does that come from?
I think that there's been something that's happened in, like, the last few shows where people are more about, like, the image of themselves, and they're trying to, like, be these personalities that they're not. And I think that the people that I met back in the day really had some content and severe, just, like, character that was beautiful. And I think a little bit of that has been lost because people are replicating, and it's been diluted as far as the content of people. It's not as original. It's not fresh. It's not real. It's not the art that it used to be.
Well, I mean, you know, it's funny you say characters because, you know, we host the challenge show, and a couple of the people that we kind of feel play the part of a character are actually some of the alumni, like as Wes, Johnny Bananas.
Oh, yeah, completely. I would say actually that Wes and Johnny Bananas, God bless you guys. I know you. I hope you see this, but they totally play up the part. Like, if somebody's going to come to you and say, let's make a secret deal, it's like, well, then don't do it in front of the fucking camera, dude. All right, seriously. But that's really what's happening. If people will approach you, they will try and, like, play the part of the show, and it's a lot of acting. And so I think that an element of the realness of the reality TV has been lost because people are too self-conscious in the situations. And if you could get more of the rawness of what people really are, I think you'd have a much better show, actually. And I think that's been lost.
So as far as the rawness of it, do you feel that no matter how MTV edits it, we're really not going to get the reality of it because of the actual people on the show?
I think it's like a forest fire. Like, you know, like forests, they grow, but they have to burn down in order to be able to replenish themselves. It's like the way that they recreate. So essentially what I'm saying is that the show, I think it's just a replica of a copy. And it becomes diluted. But the end result is that you need something new. And we're actually pitching a new show where we'll be traveling around, and it's raw.
As far as we, who's we?
Me.
So you're going to, Abram's going to give us the real world?
Yeah, no, it's not the real world. It's the real world. It would be an international show. We'd be traveling. It would really be taking you out of your comfort zone and saying, look, the Kardashians are not the reality. These are not the realities. Go down to Mexico for a little while and take a look what's going on around the world. Go take a look what's going around in India. Go take a look at the fact there's riots and U.S. embassies are fucking burning around the world, man. There is some real shit going down in the world. And I think there's a lot of people that don't realize that it's active and we're losing it in our generation. I'd like to replenish that at the same time, entertaining and educating with a new show.
And you hearing that first from, this is the first I've ever heard this from a reality TV show.
We're actually going to pitch it in New York in the next couple weeks.
Where can we keep in contact with you? Where can we follow you to, you know, see these future endeavors?
I'll be totally honest. It's kind of hard to follow me. It's part of the thing that it's a conflict for me because these shows enable me to have a voice, like in this particular instance, where we can broadcast to people. That voice is actually powerful in some aspects. What I'd like to be able to do is pair up with somebody that's willing to do the legwork that connects me with that infrastructure of fans of the shows, which is awesome. Check it out. But, like, really go after that character and try and support things like where it's real and it's raw and it's coming at you with, like, some fresh, groundbreaking ideas, man. But you can try and find it on Twitter and Facebook, but I'm rarely on it. unfortunately, I'm not very linked up. I'm going to try and keep a little bit busier with that, but that's one of the only places you can find me. Other than that, I'll be hiding out in the mountains somewhere or a different country.
Well, thank you so much for stopping
by.
That was the real buzz you later, mother.